Hola a todos, posiblemente los Duobot son de las mejores cosas que existen en el League of Legends. Desde muy temprano, cuando empezamos a jugar en nuestras primeras partidas o primeros meses, puede surgir esa gran sinergia y amistad, que es ir junto con alguien a la botlane. Pero vayamos más allá, porque en la historia de League of Legends competitivo existen esas legendarias botlanes que al ser profesionales y al haber estado jugando tanto tiempo juntos, llega un momento, una jugada que al verla solo nos preguntamos, ¿cómo esos dos individuos parecen ser una sola persona? La coordinación perfecta y las excelentes mecánicas nos sorprenden, porque hacer esto no es nada fácil. Solo siéntate y disfruta las mejores combinaciones ADC más soporte. Y empezamos el video con una jugada sumamente sencilla, pero impresionante e impredecible. Una coordinación perfecta por parte de Hillisang y su ADC, Bardax, quien en unos segundos, aprovechando la confusión y posicionamiento del enemigo, logran atrapar al ADC. Algo sencillo, pero la velocidad de estos jugadores para entender y ejecutar esta jugada es realmente increíble, dándonos esta gran reacción.
And you have so much AoE clear. Just for people wondering, he's maxing his Phoenix stats, of course. And now
even on Kalista, Pinoy gets caught. He is going to bring Fate's Call out. The bubble doesn't connect, but it's not needed. Vardax gets the kill, gets excited, and he's going to get Edward. Pinoy, look, all praise to Hillisang. He is connecting over and over. But Pinoy had flash. He's
maxing his Phoenix starts, of course, and now
even on Kalista, Pinoy gets caught. He is going to bring Fate's Call out. The bubble doesn't connect, but it's not needed. Vardax gets the kill, gets excited, and he's going to get Edward.
Uno de los nuevos soportes más sobresalientes de Norteamérica, Seisal, con un gran veterano y uno de los mejores soportes es Nikki. En un gank, estos jugadores realizan grandes jugadas mecánicas individuales para después enfocarlas en un mismo fin y terminar dando vuelta a los enemigos.
Sneaky about to finish it off, but he can't quite get it. The killer instinct, though, he's gonna get it. And Cloud9 starting to win this bot lane a little harder than Gambit would like.
And the Do-Si-Do again, Sneaky just bypassed.
Really without Diamond. Oh, Edward goes in, that's in big trouble.
Yeah, it does have his flash, but didn't quite connect it. That's gonna be a stun. Sneaky about to finish it off, but he can't quite get it. The killer instinct, though, he's gonna get it. And Cloud9 starting to win this bot lane a little harder than Gambit.
Vamos al 2015 con Origen, más específico su soporte y ADC. Mikti y Esven en una iniciación hacen lo inesperado, con Tahm Kench y Kalista logran tomar al soporte enemigo y llevarlo al equipo enemigo. Gracias a que se disposicionan los enemigos, la batalla acaba antes de comenzar.
Yeah, this is the aggression right here from him, but the Malphite teleport is in. Where's the fight?
Oh, they're gonna go back on towards Sword Art. Minthy tosses himself backwards. Neils runs away, dodges the rocket. Sword Art, Black Shield on himself, lock it as well on him. But a few more attacks will do it. There's the red, there's the kill for Neils. And Amazing finds the knockup on Akarsa. Gravity will buy some time, jumps over the wall to the wolves. Akarsa's flashless. He's got nowhere to go.
And this was actually just a fantastic teamfight realization from Minthy. Instead of tunnel vision,
he has that objective.
Yeah, so Tahm Kench comes in on one side to begin this one, which is actually what split up Flash Wolves to begin with. Obviously good play by Mithy, but then Neils is playing confidently on the other side.
They brought Sword Art in. I saw him flank right there, but he was just pulled to the side.
Yeah, that was the Kalista Tahm Kench combo that you dream of when you see the champion kits.
Vamos con uno de los momentos más recordados de la historia. Imagina, ¿qué tan viejo debe ser esto? Los inicios de Rekkles, cuando empezaba su carrera. Pero desde sus inicios, este jugador demuestra que viene a ser el mejor. Ya con el retirado, Yellowstar hace una jugada que quedaría plasmada en la mente de todos por mucho tiempo.
Ultimate subjugate steals health as well as defensive statistics, so it is something to keep an eye. Yellow's gone in,
gone flash straight in. Timber's on towards him, but there's not enough damage coming out. And now Yellowstar gets pulled in towards the tower. Diamond joins them at the top here. This could turn out horribly for Fnatic. That's going to be a double kill. The super mega death rocket. Oh, and Diamond gets flashed away by Rekkles, but can he close the gap? He's going to go in towards Rekkles. He should. No, barrier bait pulls him out, and they don't get anything. thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Super Mega Death Rocket with the X.
Uzi y Mata. Fue una botlane muy hypeada en su momento, y no es para menos, estos dos jugadores son dioses mecánicamente hablando. En el All-Stars del 2016 salen de una situación sumamente difícil, de una manera que hace que parezca hasta fácil. En un momento donde los dos están a punto de morir, un segundo después, tienen el total control de la partida.
Well, they both have all summoners, so.
Well, there's actually exhaust onto Mata. Mad Life gonna look for it as well. Uzi trying to fight Prey on the back end, but Mata's taking a lot of damage on the other end. Now Uzi takes the lantern out, hook it onto Mad Life, clean up down as well. So Flay is back onto the Tom Kench. He's forced to flash out as Mad Life passes around, but Bengi taking damages. He'll shift away. Clean up though, flashes in, wants the kill, looks for clean up as Wayless down as well. First blood to Mata, double Flay back, and now Wayless gonna try to clear them up. Prey gets one to the backside, but Bengi looking to go down as well. Oh, last thought is there, and there's the double for Wayless.
Y hablando de dar la vuelta sumamente genial, ¿quién es mejores que Aphromoo y Stixxai? Que en un segundo a punto de morir, dan esta increíble jugada. Disfruta.
Top lane with Purion still in the mid lane. So this turret's actually going to take a substantial amount of damage, especially since there's no TP.
But here comes Proxen, the stun lands, Aphra's ignited, gets the summoner heal, and they won't chase through. Gates gotta be careful, heals himself back up, and now Stixxai could knock down Proxen, and he will with Rend. He's still going forward, ults Aphromoo in, they're gonna find some damage on the Gate, who doesn't trade back. A 3-0 to CLG.
And CLG,
CLG in the early game.
Yeah. Proxen gets the cocoon, gets the jump on him, but Aphromoo with the flash and the heal there from Stixxai to keep him alive. And Proxen still looks like he wants to fight, doesn't immediately pull out and repel away.
Yeah,
so Stixxai with the chase there. Got a tweet earlier today about him being an unsung hero. He's definitely showing up in this laning phase against the bot lane of TIP.
Si Mata y Uzi eran épicos, ahora imagínate Mata y Death, que fueron geniales durante muchos años, por bastantes considerados como la mejor duo bot lane coreana a nivel mecánico. En esta jugada podemos ver cómo sacan a la jungla de una situación imposible, no solo salvándolo, sino que llevándose una kill.
Pick up the kill onto Blank. You called the Griffin special. I think they were one up. Just the Vision of Empire Coaster was just demonstrated.
We've seen it so many times. You don't pog champ every time, but this time was the time of all times. Watch this. Maximum range.
Whee!
Ride. Whee! He says as he goes all the way along. He's still suppressed.
Ludicrous stuff from Score. I'm surprised he managed.
No sé si se hayan impresionado con los puestos anteriores, pero este top 3, uff. Aphromoo con Stixxai lo hacen de nuevo. Aphromoo llegando en un instante a salvar el día a la perfección, mientras Stixxai también lo hace igual de perfecto, quiteando y haciendo muchísimo daño. Juntos logran hacer esta play épica.
Sitting on it right now, so he's farming up very, very far. Here's that macro player we're talking about.
Once
knowing
again.
The map, knowing where you are and where the rest of your team is. Stixxai gets found out, grand challenge is executed.
Oh!
Aphromoo getting in to save him. The rest, oh, you gotta be kidding me. These things can't happen because Stixxai is gonna keep making those plays, but if the team is there, let the plays be made. Onto Kirin now. There's the Witcher's Bite. Conclusive blows to come through. No place to repel to. And he gets hammered down by Xmithy. Very, very far. Here's that macro player we're talking about. Knowing the map. Knowing where you are. And where the rest of your team is. Stixxai gets found out. Grand challenge is executed.
Oh!
Aphromoo getting in to save him. The rest, oh, you gotta be kidding me. These things can't happen because Stixxai...
Como segundo lugar, cómo no, SKT en contra de TSM. Seamos sinceros, ninguna otra botlane lo habría hecho tan bien como esta, a la perfección sobreviviendo un dive en el que cualquiera hubiera muerto. Bang y Wolf no solo sobreviven, sino que nos dan el tiempo suficiente para que su equipo tome las riendas del juego.
Botlane, looks like Wolf and Bang were able to escape successfully. So SKT managing to get a kill in mid finally.
Look around this mid lane here. Oh, let's talk about Alpha because there's more action.
Again. Look at that, Bang, knocked back out from under turret. Getting low, position reversal gives him a little extra tankiness. Is it enough? The dive still so
Baker's
powerful.
Coming.
Bang is still there. Here comes Bangy too. Bang is still alive. Klitz hasn't killed him yet. Bangy gets the kill on the Lus.
last play. Meanwhile, Santorin forced away. I can't believe Bang is still alive. You know who's not going to be, though? Wild Turtle. Goodbye. A double kill for Bengi. And Faker claims another victim. Santorin goes down in the jungle.
Como una de las jugadas conjuntas más perfectas tenemos a Double Leaf y Special, quienes en 2013 hacen una outplay increíble al equipo chino bajo la torre. No te spoileo la jugada, solo contémplala.
Back into his own jungle, he said, well, my smite's up, I'll take something with it, and let it go back on cooldown. But there's a fight in the top lane.
The hook, the flay, and is that going to be enough? Flash is fine, the ignite's on him, he's going to try and use the early go. He's on nothing, Wei Xiao's tower diving though. Double Lift is going to get on towards him, the tower hits him, and now Xiao Xiao's here.
Y bueno amigos, eso fue todo el día de hoy. Dime en los comentarios, ¿qué te pareció? ¿Conoces alguna otra gran jugada? Si te gustó el video, suscríbete y dale like, de verdad me ayudas mucho. Ya por último te dejo mis redes sociales en la descripción por si gustas seguirme. Eso fue todo por esta ocasión, nos vemos en la siguiente. Adiós a todos.